నమో భగవతే వాసుదేవాయ ఓం నమో భగవతే వాసుదేవాయ ఓం నమో భగవతే వాసుదేవాయ నారాయణం నమస్కృత్య నరం చైవ నరోత్తమం దేవీం సరస్వతీం వ్యాసం తతో జయముదీరయే నష్టప్రాయేషు అభద్రేషు నిత్యం భాగవత సేవయా భగవతి ఉత్తమ శ్లోకే భక్తిర్భవతి నైష్టికి. రీడింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ శ్రీమద్ భాగవతం క్యాంటు 1 చాప్టర్ నంబర్ 18 టెక్స్ట్ నంబర్ 28. అలబ్ధతృణ భూమ్యాధీర్ అలబ్ధతృణ భూమ్యాధీర్ అసంప్రాప్తార్ఘ్య సున్నృత అసంప్రాప్తార్ఘ్య సున్నృత అవజ్ఞాతం ఇవాత్మానం అవజ్ఞాతం ఇవాత్మానం మన్యమానశ్చుకోపః మన్యమానశ్చుకోపః. Alapta, having not received, Truna, seat of straw, Bhumi, place, Adihi, and so on. Asamprapta, not properly received, Arghya, water for reception, Sundrataha, sweet roads, Avagnyatam, thus being neglected, Iva, like that, Atmanam, personally, Manyamanaha, thinking like that, Chukopa, became angry. In that way, translation and purport by is given as A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, translation. The king, not received by any formal welcome by means of being offered a seat, place, water and sweet addresses, considered himself neglected and so thinking he became angry. Purport. The law of reception in the codes of Vedic principles states that even if an enemy is received at home, he must be received with all respects. He should not be given a chance to understand that he has come into the house of an enemy. When Lord Krishna, accompanied by Arjuna and Bhima, approached Jarasandha in Magadha, the respectable enemies were given a royal reception by King Jarasandha. The guest enemy, namely Bhima, was to fight with Jarasandha, and yet they were given a grand reception. At night they used to sit down together as friends and guests, and in the day they used to fight, risking life and death. That was the law of reception. The reception law enjoins that a poor man who has nothing to offer his guests should be good enough to offer a straw mat for sitting, a glass of water for drinking, and some sweet words. Therefore, to receive a guest, either friend or foe, there is no expenses. It is only a question of good manners. When Maharaja Parikshit entered the door of Samika Rishi, he did not expect a royal reception by the Rishi because he knew that saints and Rishis are not materially rich men. But he never expected that a seat of straw, a glass of water, and some sweet words would be denied to him. He was not an ordinary guest, nor was he an enemy of the Rishi, and therefore the cold reception by the Rishi astonished the king greatly. As a matter of fact, the king was right to get angry with the Rishi when he needed a glass of water very badly. To become angry in such a grave situation was not unnatural for the king, but because the king himself was not less than a great saint, his becoming angry and taking action were astonishing. So it must be accepted that it was so ordained by the supreme will of the Lord. The king was a great devotee of the Lord, and the saint was also as good as the king. But by the will of the Lord, the circumstances were so created that they became ways to the king's becoming unattached to family connection and governmental activities, and thus becoming a completely surrendered soul to the lotus feet of Lord Krishna. The merciful Lord sometimes creates such awkward positions for his few devotees in order to drag them towards himself from the mire of material existence, but outwardly the situation appears to be frustrating to the devotees. The devotees of the Lord are always under the protection of the Lord, and in any condition, frustration or success, the Lord is a supreme guide for the devotees. The pure devotees therefore accept all conditions of frustration as blessings from the Lord. Granthra Srimad Bhagavatam ki jai, Srila Prabhupada ki jai.